Very, very warm welcome to everybody joining today at Physio Ed. My name is Dr. Harshita Mehrotra. I'm the managing director at Physio Ed. Most of you know me now. So, yeah, let's just wait for a few more people to join and I'm going to introduce the guest of honor today. Hi, guys. Hi, everybody. So nice to see people joining us on this Sunday evening. So today we have a very, very special guest with us today, and the name really doesn't need any introduction, but yes, I would like to put some light upon today's guest of honor. His name is Dr. Nitesh Bansal. He has been working, he's a physiotherapist and just a second, let me give you a complete introduction because there are some people who do not know him. Okay, so Dr. Nitesh Bansal is qualified as physiotherapist from KLE's JNMC Belgaum in 2003 and his MPT from Srinivas College of Physiotherapy Bangalore under Rajiv Gandhi University of Health Sciences Bangalore and completed his PhD from Ansar University in Gurgaon. He has established academic and clinical physiotherapy institutes at Amit University and GD Goenka University. In addition, he also had experience working with professional association bodies at national level, such as Indian Association of Physiotherapists and the Society of Physiotherapists. Also, I would like to mention Dr. Nitesh has worked as the registrar of GD Goenka University, Gurgaon, and as additional registrar at the OP Jindal Global University, Sonipat. Currently, he is working as the founding registrar at the Rishi Hood University, Sonipat. He also holds a post of professor in School of Healthcare. He's a recipient of Best Outgoing Postgraduate Student Award and many more. So, I mean, there's a lot to be told about him. And let's actually have him here so that you can know him better. So, I'll be joining Dr. Amrish Akre and Sir. Shortly. Any questions you guys have, you can keep putting them in the comment section or in the that question mark bubble you have posted there. Hello, sir. Welcome to PhysioEd.
Thank you. Thank you, Harshita, for having me today. And thank you so much for that generous introduction. I was really thinking, are you talking about me or somebody else? So that,
you know, no, thank you so much. There was a lot more to say. But I thought, trust me, let's keep it short. Yeah. So, sir, thank you so much for joining us. And I think Sir will be joining us shortly. Just a second. I'll send him a request again.
Yeah. Sunday evening, we have people listening to it. That means they have some interest. And thank you so much for organizing this where we can share with our young colleagues, because Instagram is a platform where we need to be really, we're not sure about whom we are talking to. So it's great. Definitely. It's great to be on a different channel, at a different platform, talking something. I thought it's going to be a very casual chat, but the moment you started using the word guest of honor, I got a little scared.
So definitely you are the guest of honor here. So, I mean, why not? I think he's having some problem in joining. Just a second. Anyway, sir, thank you so much for actually taking out time on a Sunday evening. I know it's a weekend for everybody, but It's great to actually see you here.
No, it's great to be here. Thanks for inviting me. Sunday means you have a lot of time on your hand. And chatting over a cup of tea or a coffee will always enhance your experience as well. So thank you, sir, for having me. I'm Amrish.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. I think sir has to join from his other ID because it shows me a notification that he's unable to join from this ID. So, sir, can you come live from the other ID? I have sent you a request. I don't think it's getting accepted.
It's like he's here. No.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hello, sir.
Finally. Hello, sir. How are you?
I'm good, Amrish. How are you? See, you got the signal now that you need to come back. Australia is too far, probably, even for internet and technology.
Yeah, but I love the nature, I love the beaches, and I love the beer, so I'm not coming back. So I'm happy. No, sir. Just the work-life balance. I'm happy at the minute. I love India. I miss India, but I don't see myself coming at least for another 2 years because the borders and the rules here are just like, can't see. Yeah. Anyways, we'll start.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Anyway, welcome, sir. And I think we are here present here on this Sunday evening to give a very knowledgeable session with Dr. Nitesh Bansal. So I think we should start.
You made me nervous by saying that knowledgeable session. Amrish would be laughing with him.
No, sir. Nothing like that, sir. You are the guest of honor, as what Harshita said here. And we are actually very, very grateful and thanking you for accepting our request and coming live with us. So, yes, sir, before we get into the session, this will just take me my idea of what I know as Nitesh, sir. He was my senior at KLE JNMC Belgaum. And what I remember from Nitesh, sir, from college days is obviously we used to fear him as juniors. That's one thing. Because in those days, things at colleges were a bit different from what they are at the present moment in terms of, you know, interaction with seniors and stuff like that. So getting to the point, sir, what do you recollect about JNMC after so many years? Like, I think you left college, your internship pass out was 2003. So it's almost 18 years. So what has changed and how has JNMC influenced you in terms of getting into administration, leadership and management? Because if I remember all my seniors and colleagues from JNMC, sir, you are right on the top in terms of administration and management, in terms of the designations you have.
See, the top depends on where you are looking at. I mean, so it could be other way also. But anyway, jokes apart, Amrish, thanks for telling me. I was actually scared. You want to say you still look so horrible that I used to get scared in your, you know, UG days.
No.
Chance that where we had ran your batch or something. But yes, I have found memory of your batch, you specifically and the other colleagues of your class and many of your seniors and juniors as well. Coming directly to your question, yes, JNMC has a big role. It has a rather big impact on my thinking, the way you perceive, because of the days where you were actually came out of a restricted world to an open world. You know, person like me who has been with a joint family, staying in a conservative kind of environment, suddenly you were put to something which is completely open. And many of you will agree, studying in a medical college, which is about 2,000 kilometers away from your home, gives you a different kind of liberty. And we really enjoyed it. But having said, the skill set, KLE JNMC, and I had a chance to go back to KLE JNMC Belgaum back just very recently when they invited me on the same stage on the same occasion, but to perform a different role where I got my degree as. So I was fortunate enough to be there in the month of March for their graduation day, where a fresh batch was coming out and the numbers were three times when we used to study. There were more than 100 people who got graduated this year. So it was a different feeling, yes. Teachers like Mukashi sir, Khatri sir, Sanjeev sir, Radha ma'am, and many of our seniors who are now in a big position in KLE, like Kage sir, Santosh Medkud, Anand Hikinawar. I mean, they had a great influence in all of us in some or the other way. And the kind of administrative skill we saw there, growing of a department from a single room to a full-fledged institution, that gave us a tremendous kind of a learning. So we can't really forget that. How to handle patients, that was a part where we paid fees for. Apart from that, how do you grow as a nice human being where you gel with everybody? Because the class itself was a mini India. We had the presentation. I'm sure you must have also experienced.
Yeah.
Unlike you know, nowadays, because there are so many colleges across
colleges
in India. So you tend to get into your own city. But during our time, we had people from across almost every state.
All over.
So
all
it
over.
Was an amazing experience altogether. Yeah. So helped us to develop as a human being.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, sir, in terms of leadership and management, how come the influence started? Was it always in you or is it something which has developed over a period of last few decades or something?
Yeah,
or you always believed you were made for it?
Yeah, you will agree that I was not a good student. I was an average student, or rather a below average student. So I was used to find something which I could get, you know, attention of my teachers or a director or faculty members. So this is something which attracted me. Managing college fest, managing those events. And I was quite active in, I don't know whether I could call it extracurricular or co-curricular, the Rotfact and Rotary. Organizing
events. I remember that.
There was no curricular component, but yes, to term this as co-curricular, yes. We used to enjoy going out and we used to wait for a reason to, you know, go out where we can go officially. So Rotaract gave us fun. We need to love connecting with people. The motive was not exactly to help them as a primary, but yes, to connect with people. And Rotary did help that. And just to share with you, I am so fond of Rotary that that's the platform which allow you to, you know, interact with anybody and anytime. That gives you a confidence, and I enjoyed that. I had an opportunity to be with Rotary since my school days. As I interact, founder, president of Interact, then Rotract, and then soon Rotary. Mm-hmm. I got this fellowship from Rotary called Group Study Exchange, where I spent about a month in a beautiful country called Finland and Estonia. Wow. So I think the whole and reaching out to other people and trying to take them along started in JNMC because it provided you so much of opportunity to interact not only within physiotherapy,
but
physiotherapy.
Yeah.
The campus was huge. We had almost every program a health science can think about. And then Belgium, it's known as so there was a lot of huge student community. So we had a great opportunity learning there.
Yeah. And of course, actually, I followed your journey right from... Yeah, I followed your journey right from you left from 2003, and what I remember of you in different time zones of Facebook and whatever social media we had, I've seen you literally in each and every corner of the world, whether it's for WCPT conference or for physiotherapy related conference, or you are in general, you and your family loves to holiday across, but you have been literally almost entire world. Is that true, sir?
No, that's not true. The entire the world is too big, Amrish, to be. I mean, you can't really say in a small life.
But like, but quite a lot. You have traveled quite a lot.
He has covered.
Yeah,
major parts.
Yeah, that's where it was. But, I mean, I have been fortunate enough to having a supportive family, supportive organization where I've been attached to work with. I've got opportunity to attend several conferences. I've got opportunity to apply for several scholarships and was fortunate to get few of them as well. So, my idea of traveling abroad is not only holidaying always. It's about looking at different perspective.
You end up because,
because you end up, you know, whenever I try to go, even like I was there, I don't know how come I missed you meeting you in Sydney in 2019, when I could meet all of my classmates, rest of the classmates there. You know, it always gives you a different perspective when you meet same people in a different country because the behavior does change.
Yes.
And when you meet who are being born there, brought up there, working there, they provide a different kind of a perspective. So there's always a learning apart from developing those connections. So my idea to travel abroad is not mainly to look at the monuments, museums. It doesn't attract me much. And I know my family doesn't feel very great about it. But yet, my idea is to talk to people, meet them, listen to them, share my views. And and how we can come together in near future. That's has been my forte.
Yes.
And that's how fortunate to attend 3 WCPT conferences. I think I have got a couple of scholarships from IASP, International Association for Studies for Pain. Rotary has given me plenty of chances to travel abroad. The institution has supported me in presenting and, you know, attending those conferences. So, that's true. I have traveled a lot.
That's great, sir. That's wonderful. Great. Amazing. Yeah.
Okay, so moving on. I mean,
but now I want to, you know, it doesn't end. It doesn't end. Harshita, if you allow me, it doesn't end there. I want each one of you to also start thinking about, you know, you really need not to be caring about your bank balance if you have to travel. There are ample amount of opportunities which are, I can tell you, there is this International Association for Studies of Pain. They're looking for people, especially young researchers. If you have slight inclination towards pain, try, work it out. They really sponsor everything you want to take it to attend their conference. Rotary International, looking for people, you know, who are professionals. They can travel to different country and represent India within their own profession. So there are ample opportunities. So I think we all should try and look for these kind of
So I can only tell you one thing now. Is that you will be having a lot of following requests and messages on your Facebook and Instagram after the session, asking them you to guide them.
I'll be more than happy. Rather, I should say, let's plan something where we can share them a link where all they can, you know, explore.
Sure, sir. We can do that because that's the basic objective of PhysioEd. You're trying to connect and help physios to get access to information which they don't get otherwise.
Yeah.
I leave the question to Harshita now. Next question. Yep.
Yeah. Okay, anyway, I think so. From all this information, I, being a young physiotherapist, I want to ask you, sir, that what do you, what would you like to say about lateral thinking? Like, I am a physio, I do not just want to stick to clinical, you know, just clinicals. So, can you actually tell me what lateral thinking is and how can it help us?
See, I'll take you back to the first question what Ambrish asked. It all starts from where you got your professional education, because whether you like it or not, try to have and imitate the people who have taught you. So that makes an impression.
Yeah.
Take a little time to come out of that sphere. So my advice to you, lateral thinking, it's not that great as it sounds when we talk about it. It's only about finalizing, you know, looking at alternate way of doing things. People generally tend to use the most easiest and the available option, whether it is to travel, whether it is to solve a problem, whether it is to look at the patient, or whether it is doing a particular any kind of job, as easy as making a tea. So I think the only thing what we need to do is to challenge ourselves and look for alternate ways. The moment you go out of routine, you find new things. And then you realize yourself also, these are the things which I've never tried. They are better than what I have been doing it. So lateral think is only and only about challenging yourself and finding a different way or a route to reaching somewhere where you have been using a common path.
Right.
For example, I'll tell you, we all want to graduate and after that we want to work in a big hospital, fancy hospital. That may be good for many people, let me tell you, but not for everyone. We know that there are professionals who are struggling, but being physiotherapists, you know, you don't need anything. The only thing you need a right approach. You need a right skill set. The moment you want to use that as a normal way, you will be a normal. But if you want to be an extraordinary, you need to challenge yourself and take a path. Start looking at different solutions, which has never been existing and never been talked about. I mean, you may take that path. You may not take. I'm not saying that necessarily travel that path, but at least start thinking about it. And the moment you think about it, you will start getting the clues and you will start moving towards that. And you will see lot of new learning and you will start enjoying that.
It is important. New learning is always important, I believe.
Always, yes.
Right.
Yeah. Okay. So coming to the leadership skills, I wanted to again touch base because I'm a bit touched with that aspect. And that's one of the main things I wanted to talk to you on Instagram Live is you have been a leader by example. And I want to know this from you, being a part in a situation where I have to lead a team at Physio Ed and try and make sure things are organized and done in the right way. Are there any aspects a good leadership will be looking at? Even for people like physios who are here, who are leading a team, what do they look at its leadership like?
Amrish, first of all, in my opinion, leadership is a highly, overrated word in India.
Overrated.
Because what you do, we kind of connect leadership with a kind of political leadership. That there is a boss.
Yeah.
Actually, leadership is not about being a boss. It's only about motivating people and trying to get the best out of them. That's exactly it.
Yeah.
And you really need not to be the boss to do that. Only thing what you need is a right frame of mind, right attitude, and a good connection with your team members.
Right.
You don't have to be in the office 9 to 5 to get the best out of your employees or colleagues.
No.
Well, bolte hai na, soch kahin bhi aa sakti hai. So you need to see what's the best time for them. So give them a freedom, show them a path and try to help them to travel that. To really not to lead them or something. The time has gone. People are smart now. We have leaders
everywhere.
Start from your family. Your mother is a leader, your father is a leader, even your younger brother is a leader, some or the other sense. It's only about owning that responsibility. You know, being a leader, what you do, you paint a beautiful picture, promise your colleagues and stakeholders that this picture will be a kind of a reality one day, and you work along with them. In order to work with them, you have to ensure you get best out of everyone. And what you need to do to get the best out of one is to understand them. Provide them a right atmosphere. Be there when they need you. Correct them when they have tried to deviate from the path, but not as a boss, but as a colleague. I think that's something
as
what
a colleague.
Learn.
Yeah, exactly.
From a physiotherapy point of view, I would like to say that you need to understand everybody's importance. Mm. Not that I'm the one who's running the show. The moment you start thinking about it, I think that's the beginning of end. For our career,
it's about making one person understand that he or she is a specific skill set and that's what they are actually a master of. It's even trying to make them understand without making them hurt or emotionally disturbed that I'm not getting the importance there, isn't it?
That's again self-created, Ambrish. That's very true. And that's a nature. Because we have been
Exactly.
seeing people whose death importance are being, you know, considered as successful, which is not exactly the case.
Not
You know, but,
exactly, no.
you know, what happens is if you're able to sleep in the night with a great satisfaction, and then people rightly say, if you're not excited about Monday, change your job. And if you're not excited about weekend,
Yeah.
change your friends. So
It's
this
the
is
wrong
something
spot.
I would like to
Exactly.
say. Please,
Exactly.
please enjoy whatever you like to do, and please do
Exactly.
what you like doing it. I mean, don't get into
This is
if there is nothing.
So this is amazing. Like I've in all the sessions which I've conducted in the talk, I think this few sentences which you said will always remain in my mind forever from here on. I can just assure you that this is such a wonderful statement that when you're trying to get back to work on Monday, if you're not enjoying it means you have to change your job. And if you're not enjoying your weekend, that means we need to change our friend circle. I'll remember this, and I'm sure many of my friends here, physios, will remember that. That's wonderful.
And it's not me.
Yes.
Somebody has told me also. Somebody has told me also. That's why you have seen I have changed a couple of jobs. So this is somebody else's. And it's not my own creation. But yes,
So
you need
yeah,
to
I'll just
change
tell about
your.
myself. Like, yeah, in 16 years, I have not worked at one job for more than 3.5 years. 3 years is the maximum I worked. I've switched after every 3 years. I don't know whether it's a good thing or a bad thing, but I've changed.
No.
Yeah,
There's nothing called as good
Harshita.
and bad. We have grown up in
Yeah.
an atmosphere where parents have been working from a same job, retiring, but things were different. The opportunities are different. So I there's nothing, there is no perfect in professional life. So I can keep doing whatever you like doing, and I can say, please do what you like.
Right.
Yeah.
Perfect, perfect. I think, okay. So, sir, coming from leadership and management and everything that you have put light on, I would want to come to a very famous topic, and it's trending as always. Physiotherapy education, India and abroad. So, can you like give a
No,
anything, any quick tip on this? What's going on with that?
I think without any offense to anybody, and I'm being a part of it, I think Indian education, there's still scope to improvement, but yet it's by far one of the best ones. I would say the
Okay.
kind of foundation we have in India, especially at the undergraduate level, there is no comparison to it. When we talk about
That's true.
international education, I haven't come across many physios from India who have gone and done their undergraduation, which is very difficult, mind you.
Okay.
They go 99%, they go for their post-graduation. And you can go
Yeah.
back and look at their curriculum. This more research-based masters, whether it is
Yeah.
UK or Australia, United States, there are
Yeah.
examples where they get to work, but mostly it is research-based because the profession is so it's controlled. You need to have a license to practice, and once you don't
Yeah.
get a practical training, it's a different set of opportunities. I'm not trying to compare. There is advantage and disadvantage both sides. It depends where do you see yourself. What's the motive of going? If you don't come back, I would say may not make much difference. After doing the graduation, definitely you will have a different perspective. But as a comparison to edge with your colleagues who have done masters within India, I have my reservations on that. But yes, in case you want to settle abroad, yes, it will be a very good idea to take up a course of a master level in the country where you tend to settle in, because that will start
Yeah.
providing you the kind of approach they have towards from a physiotherapy point of view. And as far as
Yeah.
comparing them in terms of quality, definitely they were. And India also has a great system of teaching. And you know, we have been known for our education system. When there were no universities in the world, India were known
Yeah.
for Nalanda, Takshila. And as early as about 75 or 60 years, if you try to Google or search it, we were leaders in higher education. So I think it all depends. What's your objective? It may not be fair to compare the complete number, but it depends on what criteria you are looking at. Everything has their own advantage. There
Yeah.
are people who have done their undergraduate and their post-graduation abroad, and they have done wonders. There, I mean,
Yeah.
reached to the maximum possible. And there are other ways also. People who have done masters also here, then shifted abroad. So it
Yeah.
all depends what your objective is.
Depends.
Not trying to be
Yeah.
diplomatic,
Okay.
but
I don't want to give a answer, you know, which can confuse further. It may sound as an answer right
Yeah.
now, but it all depends how
Yeah.
you evaluate that option only.
Situation. Yeah. I see myself into that
Okay.
because I worked in India for 10 years after my post graduation, and in 2018 I came to Australia, which was 10 years after I finished my PG post graduation. So yeah, I mean, I was a bit confused as well till the last minute, and yeah, I'm sure most of us are. So it's always good to get an insight like this, sir. Thank you. So I would also now like to take this discussion a bit back to our country in India. Talking about being in ACATS for around 10 years, which I was, the curriculum across the country has a bit of a difference in every part of the country. Like I'm sure there's some advantage to it. What would you say about that, about the curriculum being different in different universities?
You must have heard about this phrase called "Kos Kos Pe Badle Vani, Char Kos Pe Badle Pani." India is full of diversity. Exactly. India is much, it's like a Europe. We have so many states, so many languages, so many cultures. So I think it's good to have that diversity. We need to respect that.
Yeah.
I don't know what purpose will we serve by having a unique or, you know, kind of a curriculum which is same across from Jammu Kashmir to Tamil Nadu or Kanyakumari. I really don't know whether it will be of help. But I personally feel every university, every city is known for its uniqueness, and we should maintain that. There are certain things like human body will not change. The bones will remain 206. Of course, Hrithik Roshan may be an exception, but most of the human being will have the physiology remains the same. You need to. But how do you apply that knowledge may have some difference based on your culture, based on your surroundings, based on the kind of presentation of diseases, the evaluation method may differ. So I think we should appreciate that. We should have those minimum standards and rest all universities according to their cultural existence, they should be free to further develop upon it. I mean, I personally, in today's age, restricting what we are doing in Tamil Nadu, replicate the same in Punjab, I don't think makes much sense to it. So I will leave it to the university to have their own curriculum, strictly adhering to the minimum guidelines. So always, even, you know, the biggest council, the strongest council, Medical Council of India, now it's called as the National Medical Commission, they also prescribe minimum standard, which is 80%. Yeah. And 20%, the universities are free to explore, try to have something which they want to be known for. So I think I would not be very much for having a unified curriculum across the country. You should give that to people like who are sitting on the chair too.
Right. So that's lovely. That's the right thing which is happening here.
Yes.
Okay, yes. So I think it's happening in.
Also coming from the uniformity point of view in the curriculum. So how important do you think is specialization in the field of physiotherapy? Is it utmost important to be specialized in a particular set skill, or do you think diversity is important?
But now, let me be very honest and upfront with you. I'll share my opinion, and that's my personal opinion. I don't think we are yet there to have so many specializations in physiotherapy.
Yeah.
I am not sure, maybe I'm wrong. But it's the audience who has to decide whether we are ready, reach there, so much of content, so much of curriculum, so much of technique, that we can have a proper master's in musculoskeletal or a proper master's in neurology, adult neurology, pediatric neurology. Now we have women's health. I would say that, yes, physiotherapy is something what is there, very well accepted, very much required. And there are a good number of people who are getting into it every year. There are a good number of people who need physiotherapy, because physiotherapy is no more now part of a rehabilitation or kind of a thing which will come after disease or disorder. So I personally feel we are not yet there, but it's been happening. I myself did my master's in musculoskeletal and sports. So people now have a sports physiotherapy, which is different than muscular. Though I get to figure it out if there are sports injury, which will not be a musculoskeletal origin. So that's something we can keep talking about. So, but I feel there is the other aspect of looking at, there is a requirement of highly specialized therapists because the complexity of these diseases, the presentation of these disorders and diseases are so diverse once again because of our geography and because of a lot of other factors. We need people who are specialized in something, because some people need really specialized care. So in that way, I mean, it's good since it's happening. None of us can do anything about it. But if given a chance, I would like to have a physiotherapy program, ideal situation, which is of 5 years, where you have 3 years of physiotherapy and then you opt for area where you want to, you know, have as a
Perfect.
Major.
Actually.
And then work
major.
As a
Yes.
minor. So try to mix
Yes.
and both. But then it has to be also seen how it works. But what we call as doctoral or physiotherapy, 5 years program right after 12.
Yeah.
3 years remains common for everybody. The remaining 2 years depends on your, and you have to have two. You can't restrict yourself with one.
No.
You have to have two domains where you can work, man. And the domain also be re-looked at. It has to be
right,
so.
Sir.
But I think it's
right,
the time. And we have new education policy, which is giving lot of freedom to universities now to explore. Till 2035, I think we have a time to work upon, deliberate upon, to see where our curriculum is going towards. So I see a lot of positive changes. A lot of people who are putting their brains into it. I had the opportunity to be part of this national task force formed by Ministry of Health and Family Welfare way back in 2017-18, where we drafted a model curriculum for physiotherapy.
Wow.
So I think there are a lot of things which is happening in terms of curriculum also. So.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Perfect.
So could you tell us something about this National Commission for Allied and Healthcare Profession Act and its impact on physio? What is it like? I've heard of it. I'm not too aware about it. So could you enlighten us? Like,
no, this is something kind of we've been being thought about or waited for more than 60 years. India never had a national body.
Exactly.
Through Ministry of Health and Family Welfare has done now. They have enacted or they have instituted an umbrella body, which is called as National Commission for Allied and Healthcare Professions Act.
Okay.
So it's a commission which will regulate 56 different professions under allied and healthcare. All these 56 professions have been categorized separately into 10 different categories.
Okay.
So few likewise professions are being clubbed together. For example, medical lab technology, medical lab sciences, healthcare management, nutritionists, biotechnologists, they are being clubbed together. It's a great thing that physiotherapists are single because the numbers is huge. The science is huge. So there's one category where we'll have a physiotherapist being categorized. There will be a separate council for that at the national level within the council. Then there are state allied and healthcare council within the umbrella of commission. Every state will have a state and allied healthcare council. And within those councils at the state level, there are four boards which are mandated to regulate undergraduate education, number one. Second board is mandated to regulate the postgraduate education. Third is for ethics and research. Fourth one is for their standards rating. So that's something which is happening at the national level. And to my knowledge, I think the process of constitution of interim commission is right now going on as we talk. So any moment, within 30 to 45 days, we will have a notification about the interim board coming into existence, and that will start regulating. But I will also like to clear the sky about it. A lot of people are talking about it's bad. We should have an independent council. I don't understand. What do you mean by independent council? Do you want an independent, a right to independent practice or an independent council? What, you have an independent council, but they don't allow you to practice independently? What's the point of?
What's the point?
A council which is there to put forward your needs and demand at the right platform. Till now, no one was there in the system to talk about physiotherapists. There were people at the state level, like Delhi Council for Physiotherapy. We have in Maharashtra. Recently, we had in Gujarat. There are a lot of other states which have got councils. So, Haryana has gotten very recently. So, Jharkhand also, I heard. Tamil Nadu, there is a notification. But now, there will be a uniform council at the national level, which will maintain the register. They will prescribe certain qualifications. It's basically to safeguard the interests of population and student. So these are the things I think people have been talking about. We have been thinking about those things since we were students. The moment council will come, the whole thing will change. We all will be called doctor overnight and our salaries will become number. So that's nothing is going to happen like that. The council is a statutory body to put forward your interests in front of the government. So that's the mandate. That's something very positive which is happening.
That's great. I think it should be really helpful in future. Okay. So I think after all this huge, massive knowledge, I think the last thing that I would want to ask you, sir, is that can you actually give us a piece of advice that other than actually practicing physiotherapy, how can we work on our own venture? and probably, you know, enhance it, our own private venture.
See, I will have those three L's for everyone, which I have been following personally, irrespective of which domain you work, whether you are working in a clinical setup, where you are in an academy, or you are doing something apart from being a physical therapist. Always remember to have a liberating goal.
Okay.
Whatever you are, whichever stage of your professional life or personal life you are, always have a liberating goal. Till the time you see something far away, you will not even make an attempt to do something extra.
Exactly. Yeah.
Recently, I have heard another phrase where people talk about, we do our best and slightly more. To do that slightly more from your best, you need to have a target which is liberating a little higher. So don't even do any kind of a conjuicy in making a goal for yourself.
Exactly.
That's the first and most important thing for each one of us. Mm. Second thing is about lateral thinking. Do not depend upon conventional and usual way. Make use of them as an experience for your learning. But when it comes to you, challenge yourself. Try to go beyond your capacity and capabilities. I'm sure there is a lot of potential within you which none of your teachers and people have told you. You need to explore yourself. They can only, you know, kind of ignite some kind of a spark or facilitate you moving towards it. But it's you who have to take up the challenge. And I can guarantee you, the moment you start talking about unusual ways, you may fail 9 times, but one success will take you, you know, overcome all those 9 successes. And the kind of learning which you're going to have to those 9 failures, it will be immense. No book, no internet, no Google can give you that. And the last thing would be always ready to learn and being a lifelong learner. Don't miss any opportunity to get something new into your brain. The skills what people have been talking about are all useless now. For next 100 years, the next century, it's only and only about one skill. The skill to change.
Perfect.
As
somebody
else mentioned in the chat, change is the only constant thing. The moment you are a lifelong learner, I think there's no challenge which will be strong enough to, you know, kind of bother you for your professional or personal life. So these 3 years, which I personally have been following, and I would like each one of you can modify according to your choice and your requirements.
Okay.
I'm going to have a look at the questions below.
Sir, definitely, I think having your own personal thing is very important. And till the time a dream doesn't wake you up, it's not a very realistic one. It has to actually wake you up from the sleep, and you need to be all worried that how am I going to do it? I don't think if you're out of your till the time you're not out of your comfort zone, you're not actually going to do something great. Okay.
You need to break that barrier and try to liberate yourself from your boundaries.
Yes, true.
Okay, so sir, we have a few questions. Can we actually get them up, if you allow?
Sure. Why not? Of course.
Okay, so sir, we have somebody asking us, how can one follow your footsteps being a physiotherapist and exploring more in terms of leadership and representing our profession?
My first advice to be, don't follow my footsteps. They're very dirty right now. Don't do that. What you like doing is start exploring in that direction. In case you want to be into a administration or I hate using that leadership position. If you want to make some contribution or, you know, try to make some impact on somebody's life, try to start identify your strength, what you like doing, and strive to take up more challenges within your own professional life. Take up the opportunities which are not usually coming on your way. Go out of the way to ask your the person who is responsible for assigning responsibilities to give you that opportunity, and you try and explore. The two things will happen. You will come to know whether you are good at that, and your superior will also come to know about that, whether you will be given that opportunity. Start challenging.
Right.
That's the only thing I can say that.
Perfect.
Start taking challenges and start giving yourself a challenge that, you know, I need to do it.
Yeah.
Of course, you need to take a extra time out of your life. So that's something that you need to do. And don't try to follow anybody's footstep. Yeah. Create your own road and path.
Exactly.
That's to be original.
Try to be original.
We are trying definitely to be original.
Okay, anyway, I think we have actually covered all the aspects today, and I'm sure we are going to follow all this now. The piece of advice, definitely, sir, we will actually broaden our horizons of thinking and go beyond just the clinical practice. So
It was
thank you
there.
so much, sir. Thank you
It
so much
was
for joining
amazing.
us today. Thank you so
It's
much for your
a
time.
session which I will remember. I'm not trying to just be, very humble and say it because it's you, sir, but it's something which myself and Harshita both will acknowledge, and even our crowd after they watch it on the recording, that we have felt very comfortable in asking you all these questions, and we have got a vision after this 1 hour, nearly 45 minutes, is that physiotherapy is just beyond the normal conventional practice, and there's so much we can actually go ahead and do. Like, I have got a lot of insight from you in terms of not avoiding the leadership word and trying and being a better colleague
No, it's a
amongst,
good leadership itself. It's not, and I'm not against it. The only thing is terming somebody as a leader,
terming,
it takes a lot of time for you to recognize
exactly.
somebody as a leader. Just because
Exactly.
somebody has won election and some people have voted for him, or they consider them as a leader, will not necessarily make you follow him or leader for you. So I think my opinion is about that. You need to decide. For me, somebody who is helping me reaching my office is a leader for a particular task. I can't do that.
Exactly.
He can do it for me. So that's
Agreed.
something very different. Yeah.
That's it.
So
Yes.
great, guys.
Thank you
And
so
I
much.
congratulate each one of you for creating this kind of a platform where you can talk to youngsters, you can talk to people who are just in a place where they're moving from graduation to, or they're looking for post-graduation option. They're not aware because I remember we have also been fed about that classical mentality, what our teachers got from their teachers, and we are just passing on. I
Passing it
remember, and
on.
I gave that example the other day, collecting those certificates of attending workshops that they will help you to get a job and interview. I wonder how many Amrish and Amrita will have by now, because my cupboard is full and nobody has asked me so far. And I have never asked anybody, being on the other side of the table. And second thing, I also must say now, it's a very crucial stage, and not only physiotherapy, I think all the professionals are going through. We see a lot of social media warriors, or what we call Facebook warriors. Be aware, Instagram warrior, whatever you say. Listen to everything what is coming to your social media network, but use it with a pinch of salt, and don't let it come to your mind straight away. Use your own mind to analyze it before you make a comment, or tell whether it is right or not. There is a huge amount of information which is available, and information will remain information. You need to convert that information as a knowledge. And to convert that information into knowledge, you need to really think about it. So being a professional, don't miss that opportunity to convert that information into knowledge in case you utilize that knowledge, that information for your
That
purpose.
is a take-home message for
And that's
today,
something
then.
very dangerous.
It is. There are a lot of take-home messages. This is one of them. I'll say it that way.
So thank you so much, sir. We thoroughly enjoyed today's session, I would say.
Yeah. Thank
Pleasure
you,
is
sir.
all. Thank you for having
Thank
me
you.
here today.
Hoping to have you
Thank
soon
you so
on
much,
this
sir.
call again.
We'll have you soon sometime,
Anytime,
sir. Yeah.
I
Thank
would
you,
be
sir.
happy to be with you. Thank you. Wish you all the best. Take care. Bye-bye.
Thank you, sir. Take care, sir. Bye, sir.
Thank you,
Bye,
sir.
sir.
Good
Bye.
evening. Bye.
Bye.